Across like three different platforms. So what's up, guys? I just gotta add this window capture. Let's add a new source. Where is zoomy? There we go. Minimize that little bit. There we go. All right, we ready. So what's up, guys? How we doing? I got Michael Money here from Beyond Unbroken. We're gonna play some Dead by Daylight.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, not a problem. No problem, no problem.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Yeah, of course. So what have you been up to?
Nice. COVID has been pretty crazy, you know?
Yeah.
That whole realm is just like so gnarly to me. It's like, oh my God. It's definitely made me more appreciative of everything I have.
Yeah.
And it's just like, it's been a weird time for musicians too.
Definitely.
Yeah, it's like a weird time for musicians. Like, nobody's touring, and now it's kind of ending, so everyone's like kind of start up and look for tours again. Now yeah. everything's like, hopefully everything's like coming back to normal, I guess.
Yeah, I'm hoping so. We've been lucky enough that, like, apart from the lockdown, most of 2020 we were able to have some gigs, so that was kind of lucky on our part there, but
yeah, that's
but yeah
good.
I can imagine that's gotta, if especially if touring's like your main job, like that's gotta suck, man. Like,
yeah, like for a lot of bands, I feel like it's a really tough time for, you know, that people that are strong and that's like all they do is tour. They're
yeah.
like, tour, and now it's just like completely nothing. But
nothing. Yeah.
Just like, damn, so they must be eager, like as hell, to get back out there now.
Yeah, definitely.
For us and Beyond Unbroken, it's been a little bit different, though. We've been working the grind at, from home and stuff like that, and going in studio sessions and stuff like that, getting things done, getting, like, you know, new music for everybody, and like, because like we released an album over the whole, you know, we released an album last year over the whole COVID, and
yeah.
we were wondering if we should not do that or not. Like, we're like, because we can't really tour, you know?
Yeah.
It's like, should we do that? And we're just like, you know what? F it. Fans want music. Like, we can always do more. And, like, let's just put it out. Like, because we want, people want music. I feel like it was a weird time
awesome.
For everybody. So we're just like, yeah, let's put it out. Screw it.
Cool, cool.
That's why we started doing. And then we're like, yeah, we want to do something. Like, because we saw a lot of people doing, like, cover home at home cover songs and stuff like that, or like playing live like this or stuff like that, so we're just like, oh, let's do something really cool and let's do like a cover song, but we'll redo it and like let's put our element into it, and like what we're about, like when we were like in Escape the Fate and Beyond Broken, like what we're about.
Yeah.
And so we added like a twist of the trap world, because we really are influenced by that too, like
nice.
The trap world and like the punk rock world, and we just try to combine the two with like a, even a heathens
sweet
even
That's
like
awesome.
a heathens element that came together really well when we were writing the song, and then we're just like, oh, this would be great, because if you listen to that Little Peep song, it's like really strange, and there's like it's not a typical chorus verse structure, it's like totally different, and then so we wanted to do something and bring another element, and so we just thought of that the heathen song we loved it so much, and we're just like, this would be a great placement for something different, and so we're just like, we try to one up it and try to incorporate that into
yeah.
the song, and it we blended it, and we had to do a lot of things differently that we wouldn't normally do to blend it to where it seems seamless, so people wouldn't really know, but they kind of know, you know, like, wait, isn't that something different song,
yeah.
And then we try to do the old Escape the Fate, like guillotine type of solos and stuff like that, like we try to throw that out there in the guillotine like type of solo, so we did like the whole big build up for that song, and like the whole two-part guitar solo harmony, we're just going up, you know, that,
that's
yeah.
awesome.
So it came together like really well, we're just like
sweet deal. All right, so.
Yeah. A lot of people seem to enjoy it, though. It's like one of their favorites now.
Oh,
really,
yeah,
took off,
definitely.
So I was like, dang, that's cool.
Yeah, because I remember I showed that to my boyfriend, and like he had never really heard Escape the Fate before, and he loves those. He talks about those solos specifically.
Oh,
like,
the guillotine ones?
Yeah, the Swore is Ours. The
guillotine is this Swore is Ours one, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. That one's a classic for sure. It's always like, I think it's like something that will forever be like just known, like strong ETF when they're like strong ETF.
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah, that's a good one. Yeah, that's one thing
yeah.
I, you know, really like about you guys is the guitar work is insane. It's freaking cool.
Yeah, that's, well,
so.
That's the one thing, being a guitar player our whole lives, you know, we, and we're both guitar players, it's like, I think people
yeah.
like almost expect it now.
Just,
like,
right.
They have to do a solo every song. It's just like, okay, man, I'll do that, yeah. But then we're like, we also write songs too, you know, like regular.
Right.
Like, no, fuck that, dude. You Yeah, so every song, even if it's like a soft song.
Nice.
All right, we'll throw in something somewhere, you know. I don't know what it'd be, but yeah.
Nice.
So we're definitely throwing that kind of element and like the new material that we've been working on that I've been hinting about on other strings and stuff like that. We've been hinting on and like kind of not said anything just yet because we're trying to get everything finalized.
Right.
Like with the new music videos, and new merchandise and things like that, and just getting it all ready to like launch, and it's about to launch.
Sweet.
Yeah.
So you have a date set up for that, or?
Yeah. I signed a one song deal exclusive with a label. They're called Fixed. They're Fixed, and some of my buddies are on that label too, old friends of mine. And,
nice.
Just throughout, and they always like rave about it. And I was like, yeah, okay. So it was like a match, like, because they use a lot of their stuff for streaming and Twitch.
Oh,
and
that one.
Like they have like a thing where there's like no copyright and stuff like that. So you can play our music without getting copyrighted on stream.
Oh, awesome. That's
so that,
cool.
That was like a big reason why I was cool with it. And I was like, okay, sounds pretty tight. We can do something like that. So they're going to release like a, when the track comes out, it's going to be like a two versions of track. It's gonna be like instrumental and the vocal one too. So yeah, that's gonna come out in June, towards the end of June, or it might be early July. So I gotta confirm with the label about that, but it's all set in stone. I signed all everything. It's all good.
Ah, cool.
We got the videos already done. Everything.
There's something for all the fans to look forward to. That's awesome.
Yeah. Oh yeah, definitely. And then there's another main song we're really happy and proud about that's gonna be like the follow-up to like all our craziness and like just like who we are as musicians and like what we're all about, and like it's gonna be heavy, it's gonna be metal as fuck, and it's gonna be ripping fucking crazy solo stuff.
Awesome.
It's gonna be heavy. Yeah, and I bought a 9-string guitar. I don't have it on me. But about a 9-string guitar specifically for that song. And like it's all 9-string, it's heavy doom shit.
Wow.
So it's gonna be different for sure. But it's like a whole different vibe, but you'll hear it and you'll, oh shit, this is pretty tight. Like this is, because we like low tune guitars, we went in that realm and stuff like that, just specifically for that song that we're working on.
Wow.
It's completely done too. We're just waiting on our director right now.
Okay.
And he's doing edits after edits to get it like perfectly done right for the video.
Oh dang. Yeah, that's awesome.
I think we kinda teased it here and there what we're doing. We posted some stuff and there's kinda like a whole controversial thing with the whole leaving of Escape the Fate.
Right.
And, like, what came about it. Things like that, and it's like a lot of unspoken questions that we never answered and stuff like that. We kind of left up in the air, like, okay, how are you guys gonna respond to all this stuff? Because sometimes we get like attacked and stuff like that by Ronnie's fans calling it reverse or Escape the Fate fans and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. But people who know, they know why, what went down, what happened.
Yeah.
But we're gonna try and clarify some of that through music.
Ah, cool.
Like, so that's what the whole story and the vibe is about. And like, you know, you'll hear it and it's gonna be fucking crazy. And it's gonna be very, 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 it's gonna do something crazy. And we might get fucking attacked or something and shit. Now, I wouldn't be surprised. But we're kind of expecting that. So like, everyone loves freaking drama. Everyone loves freaking drama. And they love the old ETF drama. And so we're like, okay, we're not going to be hush-hush about it. Okay, we'll say our piece. So like, you'll say some part of it, what went down, what really happened, stuff like that.
And cool.
People are going to be really surprised, right? Yeah.
That's awesome. So you want
to... It's all in good fun, though. Like, I have no beef with the dudes or nothing like that, you know? I don't care. It's just more like telling the story of what happened.
Yeah, because I feel like there's probably people who may not I mean, obviously know that y'all left, but not maybe not know the reason.
Yeah, exactly.
So,
So we're just gonna
yeah.
give that story to them finally, kind of thing, you know, for
Awesome.
like what happened and stuff like that. Because it doesn't
Cool.
mean I hate the guys or
Yeah.
anyone, you know.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. So you wanna play some DDD?
Yeah, if you want to do all that, yeah,
Sure.
sounds good to me. I mean, sure.
Yeah.
Going.
So yeah. Yeah, for those watching, make sure you guys are tuning in to rockrageradio.com. Brad, your quest line is on right now. And also make sure you go check out all of Michael Money's socials, which are linked on the screen: Twitch, YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. It's all Michael Money TV. Go follow.
Appreciate that. Yeah, during this whole time of quarantine, I've been trying to connect with the world, the fans, and everything like that. That's
Yeah.
why I created this room for everybody. I got the logo and things like that here, and I got a story for each one of these characters behind me and
Yeah.
stuff like that. I tell throughout sometimes.
It's cool. Very cool looking with the light and everything. The lights.
Yeah, I
Awesome.
got Chucky doll. I got all kinds of horror figures up here. I got like the Nintendo field and. You know, down
Gotcha.
here. Then I got like a Pokemon kind of stuff here, and I'm still adding more stuff as I go. And like everything in here has something to do with me or something, a story.
That's
Like
awesome.
some of this stuff I got in Mexico and Tijuana.
Oh,
You know,
wow.
it's just
Cool.
yeah, it's like a whole thing. But yeah, all
That's
this
what's
stuff means
up.
something.
Nice, nice. Yeah, I have a bunch of collectibles too. I haven't put them anywhere yet because I'm just like still trying to, the furniture behind this backdrop, figure that out and stuff. So, but
I feel you. Yeah,
yeah.
I have like all kinds of like tour stories too, if you ever want to hear
Oh,
all that kind of
awesome.
stuff.
Would
Yeah.
love to hear some of those.
Oh yeah, I have some
Cool.
if you want to hear
What was probably your favorite place to tour?
What is my favorite place to tour? I'd say it'd have to be probably it was Australia.
Nice.
For Soundwave. Soundwave was
Cool.
like it changed my world of how I looked at our audience music. And I was just like, damn, I don't live in this country at all, and clear across the world, and all these people like love us and like worship us. And it was the most
Yeah.
craziest thing because we went out on the stage, and I remember it was like Justin Bieber playing on one stage, and then it was us playing on the other
Oh,
stage.
wow.
And like yeah, and our crowds were both insanely massive. It was like they said it was estimated over 40 or 50,000 people,
Oh, wow.
and per stage. And it was just like, wow, man, this is like a sea of people. You just look out and you can't see the end of it.
Oh,
And I was
man.
like, I couldn't see the end. And I was like, this is insane. I was like, oh my God. Yeah, that was you know, I forget what year that was, like 2009, 2010. That was like prime time ETF. That was like the
Oh,
high
that's
point.
awesome.
Stuff like that. But like that changed my life. Like it's like I'll never forget that tour.
That's awesome. I actually have family in Australia, so I've been there a couple of times too.
Oh,
It's
really?
pretty,
That's
yeah.
freaking cool.
Yeah, they live, well, it's kind of on an island, but off the East Coast. So,
Off the East Coast?
yeah. I was like 12 when I went there though, so
Oh,
it was a
really?
long time ago.
That's cool. Yeah.
But yeah.
But yeah, and then I have those kind of stories, and then I have like really gnarly, like why Escape the Fate is called Escape the Fate of like crazy rock and roll tour stories too, like the gnarly stuff, dark stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think like predominantly a lot of our listeners love the aspects of rock and roll. I know I've probably asked this before to some other musicians, but it's weird for me asking it, but did you guys ever get flashed before?
Did you ever get flashed? You mean like the whole the girl doing that thing?
Oh yeah, because I mean, dude, like my boyfriend's band played at the couple of these biker rallies, and I'm just like looking the other way. I'm like, I don't want to see that, but it's rock and roll, man,
Oh my God,
like.
yeah. It's like it was like a blur of that
Oh
for
wow.
sure. Like every, almost like every other show, there was something like that.
Oh, geez.
And it felt like legit full of rock star kind of stuff.
Yeah.
That happened. Yeah, that was like a regular reoccurrence. Like, that would happen like a lot.
Wow.
Yeah, and it's just like people were just, you know, they just love rock and roll.
Yeah.
Just like us and stuff at that time. Yeah. Cool. But that was like, you know, it was just like, you know, we almost like expected it at some times. It's just like, man, it's a crazy point in our lives right now.
Yeah, because I remember, I think I had asked that to, I think one of the other guys in ETF, they were like, did you not see the one for the money video?
Yeah,
I'm like, wow.
Yeah, one for the money, yeah, there was a lot of that. That was mostly, half of that was shot in Germany when we played the Download Festival.
Oh, cool.
And the other half was shot in like, Detroit at another festival. So they mixed the two up.
Nice.
And so it shows like a huge crowd and like a kind of a smaller crowd.
Yeah.
They like mixed them up. But Download. Titties galore, little collar, and then like same thing.
Wow,
like, damn. Crazy.
Jeez.
Yeah,
for sure, for sure. Just to the viewers right now, if you're not listening, go head over to rockrageradio.com. We got one of our featured artists, Kid Six, playing right now. Go check them out. They got some big shows coming up, so make sure y'all stay tuned. So,
you want to hear a crazy story?
Sure. Let's hear it.
You want to hear a crazy one? Okay. I'm not ready for this. I'll tell it. Okay. All right. Here we go. The year, picture this, is the year 2010. Okay?
All right.
The year 2010 is about 10 years ago now, roughly. But this was like prime time escape the thing. This was our era. Like, we just released, like, we were coming off of This War Is Ours, and we just released the self-titled record. And we were on tour with Bullet for My Valentine, and we were set to go to Europe. We did like a whole U.S. tour first, and then we were set to go to Europe like a week later. And so they had it all booked, and then we're going to tour in England. And so they flew us all out to New York City, okay? And then so we're waiting in our hotel rooms in New York City, and then next thing you know, the tour gets canceled. Tour gets canceled, and we're ready to go play. Like the next day, I'm not at home. I'm in New York City.
Oh wow!
And then so the tour gets canceled because we couldn't find Max, our bass player.
Mm-hmm.
He was missing. He was just gone. But we didn't know where he was, so we had to cancel the whole tour.
Oh man!
I mean, I fought for it, and I was just like, "Fuck it, let's get a fill-in, or fuck it, let's put something on tracks, and like, we'll just do the tour, you know? Like, we'll do it." Not let fans down. But and then we had a discussion about it, and then we're just like, we should support them and stuff like that. And I was kind of against it. I was more like, no, fuck that. Let's go tour and still play. You know? And then they're like, no, no. And it was like a group decision to not do it. And I was like, oh my God, I feel like it looks so bad. But anyways, besides that, so the tour was canceled. And we were stuck in New York City for like a week in our hotel room. Nothing to do. So literally, me and Craig would literally party every single fucking day, like get drunk, drink, and then just because we had nothing to do, we're just waiting to go home on our flights.
Right.
So literally, we get drunk every day in our hotel room, go party with people and stuff like new fans and stuff like that. And it was cool being in New York City, you know. But okay, there's this girl I met one night, and we went all out, okay. And then you know, one thing led to another. Up or whatever, you know, and she's cool. She was like cool and everything. I was like, yeah, chick is cool. But then the next day, I woke up like I thought I was hungover, you know, and then like my stomach hurt really bad. It's like, oh my God, my stomach's like on fire. I don't know what the hell's going on. Like, and like they're just like, eat an apple or something. I was like, I don't know, man, this really sucks. And I felt like I was dying or something because I've been partying so much on tour.
Yeah,
that I felt like I was gonna die. Something was wrong with my stomach. And so I just took it easy, and I mostly sat in my hotel room that day. And the girl calls me up, okay? The girl calls me up, and, like, Craig's in the other room, and, like, the other guy's in a different room. And then I was like, okay. So the girl calls me up, and she's like, hey, I can bring you, like, chicken soup or something like that, and we can just hang out and talk all night. You know, just chill. I was like, yeah, okay, that's fine, whatever. I'm really sick, so I wouldn't mind being babied or something like that. You know, so she comes over, she brings the soup and all that, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And then, I was like, hey, I'm really sick, you know, and I don't feel like in the mood to do anything. I just want to, you know, relax and stuff. And she took that, like, negatively, you know? And then, so she went into the bathroom. She went into the bathroom, and then the next thing you know, like an hour goes by, 2 hours go by, and then all of a sudden I'm getting really concerned, like, what the hell this girl's doing? Like, because I barely know the girl, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I just thought she was cool and stuff. So she's locked in the bathroom. I went to go check the bathroom, she locked herself in the bathroom. And then I started knocking on the door, and I was like, hey, are you okay? Is everything all right? And she wouldn't answer, and the sink was on. She was like, had her phone out or something. I could hear her like mumbling. And then so I knocked louder, and then she finally opened the door, and she was slicing her wrists open. She was slicing her wrists open.
What the?
And my room, my whole hotel room is completely white. Like everything in the room is like white sheets, white bedding, everything you look is white. It's like really expensive too. And but there's blood all over the bathroom.
She comes at me
and she's like, you don't love me, oh my god, you don't love me.
Oh my god.
And then she like throws herself all over the bed, and the bed is she's completely naked for some reason. She's completely naked. And she throws herself all over the bed, and there's blood everywhere, dripping all over the bed sheets and stuff like that. And then she was, like, threatening to cut me with a razor blade. Yeah, and I was, like, all sick and dying, and I just ran the fuck out the room, you know? And I banged on my tour manager's door. I was, like, go down. This guy who worked for me, he's like, oh, I was, like, go down. And he's like, oh, what's going on? He's like, the girl, she's going crazy. She's like cutting her wrists open in my room. Man, what the fuck?
Oh, my God.
And he's like, what the hell are you doing? And then so he ran up there, and I was like, I'm not going back there. And then I'm like, I'm staying in this room. I don't want her to know where I am and stuff like that. And so the police were called.
Oh, shit.
And the police were called. Total rock star fucking shit. And then the police were called. And then they went up to there, and then they escorted her out.
Damn.
Room was covered in blood. It looked like a fucking massacre, like American Psycho.
Oh, God.
Four-story massacre, like, full on, man. And it was like, it startled me, and man, it was the most gnarly shit I've been through. Girl trying to kill herself in my room.
Man, and I thought some crazy stalker fans were
just
bad.
That's just like one story.
Oh, my
okay?
God.
That's just one story.
Damn.
Yeah. Yeah,
wow. But, yeah, that's insane.
Yeah. That's one of our stories. Yeah.
Jeez. Story.
So,
dang.
I'll save another one for next time.
So, yeah, I heard y'all played Rock and Rio right before. I think it was right before Iron Maiden, right?
Yeah.
That, I remember hearing a story about that. Just like kind of what it was like opening for somebody that iconic was like, man, that's awesome.
Yeah, and the thing is, whenever something like that happened, AP, the magazine company, mm-hmm. they would jump on it, and then they would, like, envelop it and be like, these guys are total rock stars, man. They're fucking girls are cutting their sets
up.
Oh,
my God.
I'm like, what the
hell?
The way they write up the stories is just hilarious.
Wow.
But it's cool,
damn.
Whatever. You know. Yeah. So, man, these guys are true rock stars. Yeah, they're so cool.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah, I know. I can't say I've heard a story like that before.
Yeah, I got a few.
I've heard some stuff, but not like that. Wow.
Yeah.
So, yeah, you want to try, like, running away from some killers here?
Hell yeah. Sure, why not?
Awesome. Yeah, so we got, thank you, Chloe Hicks, for the follow. What's up?
Chloe Hicks,
how
are
you
what's
doing?
Up? Chloe. I always wonder if that name was like Cleo or Chloe, and I get it wrong, probably. Like just when I instantly glance.
Yeah, there's been some, man, I swear, like there's been some weird streams, like when I first started streaming, that like these people would come on and just like, you know, say some weird shit. I'm like, my mods are like, you know, trying to kick them off and stuff and ban them. I'm
oh,
like,
really?
Yeah.
I've gotten the weird stuff. What's just funny is like, lately a lot of my streams have been primarily girls, and it's funny because like I feel like mostly guys would want to watch guys play video games or something like that.
Right.
But a lot of them have been like women and stuff like that, which is mm-hmm. totally fine. But then some of them get like really nasty sometimes in the stream. They'll be like, "Oh my god, I want to do this."
Oh
and
wow.
I'm just like, "Oh god." And I just kind of like quickly, briefly looked over it, and I'm just kind of like, "Yeah, okay, yeah, cool, thanks." For hanging out.
Wow.
But yeah, it gets funny. It gets fun.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
I don't mind it, you know, but it's just something that happens.
Oh yeah. Yeah, I imagine so, especially, you know, being at your level, famous musician and stuff, I'm sure that, you know, because I've seen, you know,
yeah.
being the girlfriend of a lead singer, I know these things, so.
Oh, God, yeah, you know how
it is. I do
Jesus.
Know. Yeah.
So, you want to send an invite?
Yeah.
And,
I've got
in
you.
The lobby. You can play cool. as Survivors.
Yeah.
Together. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, because I don't see any of my other friends on, so.
Oh, good. Just click ready, I guess.
Yeah. Cool.
Yeah. Which character do you like to play with in this game?
I usually play as Cheryl just because I really, really like Silent Hill.
You really, really like Silent Hill?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's the girl from Silent Hill?
Yeah.
How come I never realized that until you just right now?
I don't know. Let me bring... bring a toolbox. See if we got any offerings.
Do you use your loadout?
Yeah.
Which one do you like to use? Do you like to use like the toolbox or
I
like
think
so. This with the killers and stuff like that?
Or? Yeah. Yeah, because like I haven't been on Dead by Daylight in a while. I've been working that Crash Bandicoot 4 a lot.
Yeah, Crash Bandicoot, man, I
yeah.
feel you on that.
Yeah, like, you gotta get that, man. It's good. They
yeah,
did a
fun.
Good job with the new
Number
game.
Four.
It just like, looks really, it's super awesome, man. Like, but it kind of gives you like that same old school vibe, though, still.
Oh, okay.
But they,
yeah,
you know, they
okay.
updated the graphics. I think they added a new character, too, which is like, you have to play a little bit to, like, unlock that part. But it's the boss level for Engine. Oh, my God. I had to do that so many times. I'm like, man, fuck this.
Jesus.
I've almost rage quit on that. But, yeah, I did. Yeah, it was kind of annoying, but.
Yeah, it sounds fun.
Yeah,
I love the old Crash
Bandicoots,
for sure.
Oh, yeah, same.
So, yeah, it probably is fun. I gotta check it out, for sure.
Yeah, it's freaking awesome. Especially because, like, I grew up on that, so.
I feel you, yeah. Me and my brother, we do play a lot of Dead by Daylight.
Oh, nice.
And, like, he is, my brother is, like, a phenomenal killer. He's, like,
oh,
a
wow.
ring one. Stuff.
Okay.
He's, like, all about it.
Cool.
He's really gnarly. And, like, what's part of, though, is Survivor. I really like Survivor
yeah.
and like the ranking system, how they do it. Mine, they reset it like every month. And
yeah.
So you have like a rank 11, your rank 20, for like a new character and play. But like, it gets so difficult the more you like you rank up and stuff down.
Oh, yeah.
Down to like
Definitely.
The 8, 9, because you get more way difficult killers and stuff like that. It just
but,
yeah. Yeah, like all the they use like claymation and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Too. It's really cool and funny. Yeah,
yep.
I totally dig it though. It was an amazing horror movie series and stuff like that. The guy is like an iconic character.
Yeah. Army of Darkness. I remember that
Army
too.
Of Darkness. Did you see the new Evil Dead?
The remake. The remake. Yeah, I did.
What did you think of that?
I actually liked it. Just because, it's more, up to date with the graphics and stuff, and, you know, they use, it's not quite as fake looking.
Yeah, it was way brutal, that's for sure.
Yeah.
It was way more brutal.
It was cool, though. I liked it.
So I picked the health kit. I'm gonna, if I get hurt, I can heal myself.
Awesome. Yeah, I got the toolbox.
What you do is there's maneuvers you can do to you can get really gnarly. You can do a 360 around the killer once you really
start
playing hard enough.
Cool.
Yeah, there's moves you can do to avoid the killer from hitting you. Cause, you gotta get good at looking behind you. It's the real trick. When you get good enough, you can shift around the killer fast enough where he can't hit you. And that's what I'm working on. But it's so hard and difficult, but I watch people do it and they make it look so easy. And then they just mess with the killer all the time.
Oh, wow.
The killer can never catch them.
Dang.
They play around the killer and the killer gives up because it stops them.
It's
so
brutal.
Funny. Some people get really gnarly with that killer.
Yeah, I know. I've seen some people on Twitch play it. I'm damn.
Yeah.
Can I be that good?
Yeah, people on Twitch play it, and they're, insanely good. Some of them, there's, competitions even, and stuff like
that.
Wow.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me.
Yeah. Yeah.
Dang.
So I'm trying to get really good at it, but I kind of suck still.
Yeah. I feel that. Me too. Yeah, I'm better at doing killer, honestly. Killer rounds are,
Some people prefer killer a lot. It is really fun hunting. But the killers can only see in 2D. The whole time.
Yeah.
And with survivors, they can see in 3D, so they can see all around. But
some
people use that to their advantage. Because the killer only can see 2D.
Yeah,
so
I
you can
imagine.
Hide in certain spots, and the killer can walk right by you. It's just the way he's faced like this and stuff.
Yep. Yeah, let's see if I can be not the first person to get hooked this time, because
I utilize lockers.
Yeah.
And I walk around, I don't really run around. I'll crouch around, stuff like that, but I immediately usually start working on generators.
Woohoo! I can.
Yeah. If you hear that heartbeat though,
Lock
that and hide. Here comes a killer, I see him pass right by me.
Oh.
It's a doctor.
Oh.
The doctor sucks.
Oh my god. I just ran right into him.
Is it?
Wow.
Oh, I see. You're right next to me. I'm in this.
What did I say about not being the first person? Well.
Yeah.
Man. After I just sabotaged a hook, too.
Okay.
Are you just gonna stand there?
Yeah.
You guarding me?
I can get you off the hook. Don't worry. The killer is just right by you. Is he
He's Okay. Well, now he's going up. He went up.
That's called camping when a killer does that.
Here, come over. Oh my god.
I see him. He's right next to me.
I'm running.
Okay.
I'm following you. I think.
Are you still on that hook?
No, but I'm down. Oh man. He's right behind me. There's somebody else there trying to distract, so, okay, cool.
Yeah, I see you.
Yeah, he's sticking
that's
around.
Me right there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's me right there. I was trying to help you out.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I hate the doctor. Don't.
Just trying to heal yourself first.
Yeah, I'm trying to.
Yeah, then I can come over and let you
okay.
out.
Okay, I'm...
Dang it.
I escaped, it said, I think.
Yeah, we're all trying to mess with the killer.
I'm sticking over here by a wall. Hopefully he doesn't find me. Oh, somebody got hooked. Oh no.
Just try and jump down.
Let me see if there's a way I can help with it.
Yeah.
Or he just hooked somebody.
Usually,
okay.
That's somebody else hanged, right? Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's camping. I hate playing with people that camp like that. They camp.
Oh, are you kidding? He used
like,
madness.
They camp around right when they hang you. They camp and they don't leave. Like, they just stick around. Makes the game kind of weird to play.
I'm trying to go for
I
it.
I see. Are you working on this generator?
Yeah, I am.
Yeah, I see. Are you hurt?
It's possible.
You can see the killer, he's just hanging out on that hill to the, like, the left of you.
Okay, yeah, I see him too. Let's...
We work on this generate together, we can finish it faster.
Yeah.
Yeah, you gotta watch for those skills.
Yeah,
points.
I know. I didn't hit it fast enough. That's lame. Yeah, he's just sticking around that one hook. I would have thought he would have,
Yeah, he's being lame camping around this.
Oh man, is it too early?
It's like, what are you doing, Raven? Messing up the generator. Here, let me heal you.
Oh my god. Yeah. At least we got that one done. He's over there by that hook still, so. It looks like he's just standing there.
Yeah, he just. He come over this way.
Yeah. Oh, hold on. I'm gonna sabotage.
He's still around that hill.
Yeah.
Heal this person.
That, I sabotaged the hook. So hopefully that helps too.
Yeah. Are you getting that locker? I utilize the lockers.
Yeah, I hear the heartbeat.
Stuff come over here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just be careful. Okay. I usually kind of look up to find another generator.
Okay.
You'll see kind of the lights glowing.
Yeah, this other person's trying to tell me, come on, come on.
Yeah, he wants you to come out so he can help do generators.
Okay,
but
fine. And I just... Let me out, Alright, let's go. I'm gonna sabotage this first.
I'm in, like, that boat thing to the right. I'm working on a generator right now.
Oh. Okay. I see the boat. It's a steamboat.
Yeah, I'm in the boat.
Cool, cool. Where is the gen?
I see the killer. He's like to the right of the boat.
Oh, she told me to collect.
Kind of coming over here.
I don't want to use your freaking med kit box.
Yeah, he's chasing me.
Oh.
Shit. You should have chased me, but I'm too good.
Yeah. Okay.
Just like going with them.
Yeah. Yeah, because I hear
yeah,
that.
You guys just work on generators. He's up here on the ship.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so just work on generators.
Yeah, I'm running and going. That's one we already did. I think I see one over here. Oh, are you kidding? Oh my god. What the? So he's just
And
doing
he's still
it.
on the boat, so.
So he's just portraying a vision then.
Yeah, he's
That's.
just been trying to chase me this whole time, and I'm dodging him pretty good.
Wow.
He's not that great, so that's a plus.
Yeah.
Yeah, but sometimes when he hooks you, he just camps, and I hate that. Because it makes
Yeah.
it not, like, fun to play sometimes.
Yeah. Ooh. Got a great skill check. What's up? Except that wasn't it.
Yeah, he hooked that other girl and he's just standing like right by her.
Skill check. Is he still over there?
Yeah, he's following me. He's trying to come after me.
I'm just trying to repair this gen because there's like four left. Yeah, I really don't like that skill he's using. Just like appeared right behind me and then disappeared, but this is like almost finished too. On.
Trying to find another generator right now
Yeah.
that I could work on.
Oh god, he fucking found me.
Oh,
No.
I see him. He's chasing you, huh?
Yep.
I'm like right to the right of you.
Try
I'm trying to
using
get
that.
his attention away from you. I'm right
Yeah.
behind him.
I'm trying to run in like circles so he doesn't. You can use that all you want. Stop. Kidding. Well, that was fun for a while. He got me.
Oh, did he?
Yeah.
Ah, dang it.
Oh,
Oh, I see you. I think you
it's
could
only the
still, if
second
you
hook.
do,
Oh,
yeah.
God.
He got me.
Ah, dang it.
Faster. Put me down. Put me down.
Man, I died.
Put me
Was
down.
not fun.
Let me go. Screw you, buddy. I'm about to get out. Oh, I got out.
Let's upgrade, I guess.
You gotta
So,
look for the hatch. If you're
yeah,
the
I know.
last person, the hatch opens up. You can like crawl out and win that way.
Yeah.
He got me.
Oh.
Crap.
Let
No!
me see.
No! Screw you, buddy.
So it leaves off on that one.
So, yeah, I'm dead. Yeah, I died. Screw you, man. I hate you. I'm dead. Dang it. Lame. Lame!
You want to talk to this potion and credit you?
Yeah, if you want to do that, don't you have the same app I do?
For what?
For the editing.
No. Yeah. I do it on your phone if you want
to. Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, usually if you're like the last person, the hatch will appear and open up, and you have to listen for it, and you'll hear like a fan, like kind of noise.
Gotcha.
If you find it, you can go right through it and win the game that way.
Alright.
Usually.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm just saving all the ones you sent. So, yeah. Give me a moment to.
Yeah, that killer was like camping hardcore and all that stuff.
Yeah.
And the other people weren't really working on generators, which is weird.
Huh.
So that made it weird to play. They're like just running around.
Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, not one.
Get in there and start working on generators.
Yeah.
You can just utilize those lockers a lot and stuff like that.
Yeah. It's like hide and seek.
Yeah, it is. Kind of like that, like some of my friends, that's all they'll do is just like literally play hide and seek. Won't even do anything else though.
Dang. Because I think most people I know that play, usually work on the generators that I've seen.
Yeah, usually they work on the generators pretty quick. And,
yeah.
That was a weird game because like the other people weren't working on. But usually it's not that long.
Just whenever you save a picture, don't forget to click on the little big six photography watermark and just place it inside of it. You have to do it for each one. Unless you just want to.
I'm just going to credit you, look.
Alright. I'm just upgrading.
Are you upgrading your character?
Yeah.
Oh, cool, yeah. You should probably click ready when you are ready.
Yeah.
So I can start searching.
Cool. I'm going to go ahead and click that one.
One guy I really like is the Jake Park guy. He's really quiet. Like, when you run around with him, it's like all quiet.
Oh, that guy. Yeah.
Yeah, he's really quiet. This perk is called Iron Will, and that perk makes it like where he, if he gets hit or if he's running or something, he's just quiet.
Oh,
and like that makes it harder for the killer to find him. So. Yeah, and he has the perk called Calm Spirit, and that's where like the little crows that signal to the killer like where you are, they won't do that. So he's like a really stealthy character to play with. He's pretty cool because he's super stealthy.
That's cool. Sure, I fix my loadout. Chinese firecracker. That's cool. An event item. Gotcha. What about this?
So, how long have you been streaming for and stuff like that?
Kind of on and off. honestly, but I think it was sometime last year, I think. Yeah. And I started doing it more because of my radio show. So yeah, I do like giveaways and stuff.
No, that makes
sense. You send it? Okay.
Yeah, it's the little one that has the box with the up arrow.
Oh. Yeah. Yeah. But yeah, it's pretty fun. It's funny because I actually started out, the Radkey Request Line started on Twitch.
Oh, okay.
So.
Yeah. We press camera roll for underneath where the watermarks are.
Oh. Yeah. I'll save it. Yeah. Oh. The only thing that sucks about this game is it takes forever to find that.
That's the one really shitty thing about this game. It does take forever to find a match.
Yeah.
Like you'll be sitting here for like a good solid 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, what the heck? They need to fix that for sure.
Yeah.
In this game. That's the one thing that sucks.
Yeah.
Once you play, though, it's, like, actually cool.
Yeah.
Like, it can be actually fun. They fix that.
Nice.
Where's your stream room, like, in your space? Where do you put it?
It's upstairs.
Like, upstairs.
Yeah, I have this whole like my desk and everything. I got the monitor over here, ring light up there, my microphone.
Nice.
I got these really cool Mackie speakers too for the computer. So.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
That is cool. That's yeah, I don't have any speakers in my setup. I just use headphones mainly.
Yeah.
I want to get some nice speakers, and I'm looking into like an actual standing desk.
Oh, nice.
Stuff like that, so I can like actually play guitar on stream, like standing up.
Yeah.
Like that. Stuff
yeah.
Like that. That'd be nice to do that.
Yeah.
Just like sitting here, you know, stand, stretch and stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, my Twitch room is like I have a 3-story house, so my main studio is on the top floor where me and my brother work out of all the music. It's a giant studio.
Oh,
so
wow.
We just made it, like, decked it all out. It looks really cool up there.
Nice.
And then I made this room. It was an off room, like, and I was just like, hey, I want to turn that into, like, the whole Twitch studio kind of vibe thing.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, the room itself is, like, it's, like, a good size, but it can get, like, really hot with, because I just, like, upgraded my PC. And it's pretty much like a heater now.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it's like a fucking heater. So the room gets hot, like, quick. And even if it's, like, cool outside, it gets hot quick. So I have my window open right now. I have my window open, and it's cool outside, thank God. And I got, like, a fan above me going right now.
Cool.
Because it gets hot, like, quick, really easily. It's so funny.
Yeah, that's why I always, like, I hated streaming during the day, because they're, like, got a window like right here, and the Texas heat kind of sucks.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Sure. The Texas heat. Which part of Texas are you in?
Well, we're in Houston.
In Houston, so it doesn't get like muggy and kind of humid?
That's an understatement.
Understatement?
Yeah. Yeah, it was like yesterday, it was really, really hot, and they had an outdoor show, which went really freaking awesome. It's a cool place, but it just they didn't have a cover or anything, but yeah, we got roasted.
Dang.
It was
sweat and stuff.
Yeah.
From all the humidity.
Yeah.
I live like in a part of California where we get like some humidity, but I live like a little bit inland.
Oh, okay.
And like so it's not too bad. Like people that live like right on the ocean though, it's like insanely humid.
Yeah.
Stuff like that. Even the summer, like July next month, it's gonna be super humid and shit like that over here.
Yeah.
We have our moments, say. But Houston is I'd say is way more humid.
Yeah.
I've been there. I know
man,
what it's like.
Yeah.
I've been there. I played the House of Blues there a few times.
Oh, nice. Awesome. Yeah, I was going to ask where y'all played here, because I know recently they played a like Scout Bar and stuff.
Scout Bar?
Yeah, it's on the south side of Houston.
Main one I do remember is always Alpha Blue, though.
Yeah. Did y'all
But
play
they have these,
Warehouse?
like, a few different areas.
Did y'all play
Well,
Warehouse Live before, right?
probably, is it the giant outside kind of one?
No.
There's a giant outside one. I don't know if it still exists anymore. They would always serve barbecue a lot, too.
Trying to think what one that would be.
Yeah, or it might not exist anymore. The venues come up and then they come down still.
Yeah, was it it wasn't Proof Rooftop, was it? That was an outdoor one. They completely redid
It
it
was
now,
an
but
outdoor place, though. I know we played it because we played it at Bowling for Valentine's.
Oh, did y'all play at the Woodlands Pavilion? It may have
Probably.
been that one.
Yeah, might have been that one,
Maybe.
honestly. Yeah, it was always like pretty massive shows. So they'd put them
Woodlands
like
Pavilion sells
outside.
like brisket and stuff, right? Yeah, I think it probably was the pavilion because that's the only outdoor one I can think that
Yeah,
actually sells
that
beef
makes sense.
brisket. Yeah, that's massive.
But yeah, I played you guys' House of Blues a lot. It's really nice. That was
Yeah.
always like a really good one. They served like the best catering food, I'd
Oh,
say.
nice. Cool.
Yeah. Gotta say. Well, this is like a new level that they added. This is new. I haven't played it too much. I see you. You're right behind. I'm right behind you. I try to signal to you
Yeah, I see
with
that.
that. It's like, where's the generator? Oh, there's one
Reunited.
right here in the barn. We can all work on
Yeah.
it and get things done. Okay. All right, I hear the killer already coming. Oh, wait.
Oh, that was me.
Damn
What the? Now we're gonna use this toolbox repair.
Oh my God, we're gonna die. Let's get out of there.
Oh my God. Are you kidding? Every time. Like there's not.
I see you.
Trying to recognize what killer is that?
That's one of the kind of the newer ones, but he has like a shotgun where he swings. He can shoot it, and it can like be retractable and
My
come back
God.
at you.
Thank
Like,
you.
so you can be far away, and he can shoot it and like reel you in.
I'm keeping an eye on all angles here.
I'm gonna steal you. Got your back. It'll be okay. You're good now. Sabotage this hook. There you go.
Oh, you did
He's
it.
right behind you, the killer, so I'd recommend him going this way.
He's over there. Jeez.
Oh, my bad. Sorry, bro.
Oh, there's another one.
Find a generator.
Yeah, I did. There's one behind
Wow.
this rock.
Cool. Just keep working on that generator. You'll be all right.
Nope.
These people suck. I'm gonna keep saving them.
I think I escaped.
I've just been trying to save the other people.
Oh, wow.
There we go. Now I'm working on a generator, finally.
I found another one.
I hate that heartbeat thing, man.
Yeah.
It's like the killer's near you, but you can't find, you don't know where he is.
Okay.
Leave me alone, killer. I have to finish the generator.
Okay.
There we go. I don't know where anyone is.
Over here by all these hay bales.
I finished one. I'm working on another one. Those other people aren't very good.
Mm-hmm.
They keep getting caught.
Yeah, I see that.
Oh, no. Screw you, bro.
Oh, man. Okay.
I'll come over to save you.
Okay. Oh, dear.
Unless I get caught. Dang it.
Alright, somebody got me.
He hit me down.
Dang.
I kept saving these other people though, they're not very good. It's hard for me to complete the generators. I got one though.
Cool.
Alright, somebody picked me up. Here we go. I'm about to finish another generator.
Yeah, I'm working on one. Oh. Oh. He found me.
Oh, no way.
Oh, no, no, no. Okay.
that your second time?
Yeah.
Ah, oh, dang it, you died, huh?
That's okay.
Dang it. Try to save you. You died too quick.
Yep.
Yeah, he's coming over here. Man, these people suck. Dang it. You can spectate sometimes and see what, like, how we're playing.
Yeah, I see.
Yeah. I'm in a locker right now.
Yeah.
I'm in this locker and I'm gonna just get out. Oh wait, he's coming back. He's coming back. There he is. No! Damn it. He saw me get in the locker again. I was like, dang it. I think this is only my first time being back though.
That's good.
I see people all around me. Somebody save me. Help me. Thank you so much.
It looks like there's only two generators left. So.
Come on, bro. Help me out. Oh, you suck. And that other person just ditched me.
Oh, wow. Turn on the Raptors radio right now. That's the second one.
Yeah, these other players aren't very good, dang it.
Yeah. Watching this one other one is like trying to run away from the killer.
You got a generator, you did one. These other people are kind of messing around.
So this killer is kind of decent, playing wise.
Yes. There's only two of us left.
Uh-oh.
Oh, I'm running this way. Screw you. Every man for himself or woman.
Yeah.
Oh my god, there he is.
No!
Screw you! Damn it.
Wow.
Oh man. Oh, I'm screwed.
Wow.
I see the other person, they're like so far away from me. Damn it.
Did you go after them, I think?
Yeah, I'm just trying to heal up at least. So I can just walk around.
Yeah. He's going after the other person.
Yeah. They weren't very good anyways, so they're probably going to die. What I can do, sometimes when this situation happens, the killer sometimes will catch the other person and kill them, and then I can crawl out to a hatch.
He's coming.
But he knows where I am, I think. Oh, wait. Nope. He's looking for me.
Wow.
He's looking for me. I'm going this way. Screw you, ma'am. Yes, he doesn't know where I am. But,
he'll probably go after that.
I might bleed out to death, though.
Oh, no.
I don't know.
Yeah, he's looking for the other person right now. Where's the hatch? Hatch is open.
The hatch is over there?
Yeah.
By that person?
Yep.
Oh, no, he closed it. So that's another thing is you can close it. So now I'm really screwed. I'm probably just going to die.
That's lame.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm dead.
Damn.
Dang it, screw you, man. Yeah, I'm dead. We're so close. Dang it.
No.
We're so close. All we have is like one more generator left. And I'm dead. Damn it. I mean, that game wasn't as bad, though.
Oh, the first one? Yeah.
Yeah, the first one was pretty bad, I gotta say. Let me see. Yeah, that guy's, he's a rank 19 killer. But he's pretty good. He wasn't terrible. He's pretty good. These people are actually decent ranks. How come they kept, like, dying? They kept getting attacked. Annoying, and I kept saving them. I saved a bunch of those people.
Man,
but usually my strategy is just like when I start, I go straight to the generator, and then usually I'm not always having to save people. But every those past two games, everyone just kept getting caught.
Yeah, for sure.
I wanted to go save them each time. But usually I knock out the generators pretty quick.
Yeah, let's see if I want to play with somebody else. Level up these other characters.
Yeah, each one does something different. Like, he's a stealth character. Meg Thomas has a thing called Decisive Strike and a Sprint Burst. So, if you save somebody off of a hook, and the killer tries to kill you, pick you up, you can punch the killer and get out of his grip.
Oh, wow.
And so you can run out of it. So, Meg Thomas, the other person I use, she has that Decisive Strike thing. It's pretty cool. It's very useful. Where is she? She's my best character, this girl.
Yeah.
I have her, like, her leveled up everything.
Cool.
And then she has the Sprint Burst, too, where she just can sprint and run all the time. Get away, and then, all the time. It's really good. She has that Sprint Burst. And then that Asian girl, I don't know the
Asian girl's
name.
Oh, thank
you, man. She has a sprint burst too, but it's more when you jump out of a window, it'll activate a sprint burst. Or you jump off of something, it'll activate a sprint burst.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, so the Asian girl is really cool. It's very stealthy. I'm not sure much about the Kate. I forget what Kate does, kind of. What her perks are.
Yeah, I'm not sure. Let's see.
I know Meg Thomas is one of the best ones though in the game. So yeah, I play with her a lot. Me and my brother always use Meg Thomas. We're big Meg Thomas fans. What's your favorite escape song?
Oh, wow.
If you know, remember any.
Well, there's a few, but let's go with This War Is Ours, I guess.
Well, Oh, this store is ours? Yeah.
Yeah. Except I hear nothing.
Love it.
Nice.
And everyone's like, when I ask them what their like favorite song is, it's always like, My Situations.
Oh god.
Like, yeah, okay. Situations. They always love that one though.
Yeah.
It's the most requested song in the world.
Yeah.
What was funny is that song was supposed to be a single at first, and then it became a single last minute.
Oh wow. Yeah.
And then it came off of Not Good Enough, Truth or Cliche, that one was good. And,
yeah, I like that.
Situations originally wasn't intended to be a single, actually.
Wow.
Yeah, I don't know when we shot that video. We came off of my very first work tour ever.
Mm-hmm.
And like, back then, I used to be like a tech guy
for the band,
because they still had another member that was the other guitar player at the time, Omar. And so I would go out on tours with them, and I would like take care of the stage setup, so I'd do all that kind of on-hand stuff.
Oh.
And so when the video came, we shot it right after the Warped Tour 07. That were two or seven, yeah, way back then, because it was like the very first Situations video, and like we rented like a high school thing to shoot it in, and a bus, and we got this fat kid,
yeah,
to be the bus guy, to be in the bus, stuff like that. It was really funny,
yeah,
and we just wanted to do like the whole Van Halen, rendition of Van Halen music video, Hop the Teacher.
Ah,
so that was like the original plan for that.
Nice.
Yeah, and then like, I had this scene, like I wasn't planning on being in the video at all,
mm-hmm.
and the director just came up to me, and like, because I was just chilling, you know, I wasn't planning on being in the video at all. I wasn't going to be in it. And then like, the director came over to me and was like straight up asked me, he's like, hey, you seem like you could be in the music video. Do you want to be in this video? I was like, what? No, not really, but okay.
Wow.
And he's like, I have this idea for a scene where you get shoved into a bunch of lockers.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And I was like, okay. And then, like, we're planning it out. And I actually had a lot of beef with the guitar player at the time. Like, we weren't on good terms. And so when we shot that scene, he really fucking pushed me into the lockers. And that pissed me off, and then we got in a scuffle for like a second about it, but then the director is like, that was so good, you guys are doing so good, keep doing what you're doing, just keep doing what you guys are doing. So I'm like, oh, fuck it, okay, just shove me into the lockers, whatever. And it's like, fine, that's fine.
Wow.
It's like, so we really did it like that, but it came in like an iconic thing, like where I get shoved into the lockers.
Oh, wow.
It's funny.
Yeah, it's gotta be fun shooting music videos though too.
Yeah, shooting music videos are really fun. Gosh, man, there's something for each one of them. Like when we shot 10 Miles Wide, we had like Ron Jeremy, like the freaking king of porn back then, and like all these different random like
stars
were in it.
Josh Todd
like,
was on that too, right?
We got Buck Terry. Josh Todd.
Yeah.
It's so funny because, like, all these. We shot, like, an X-rated version of the video, too.
Oh, yes,
like,
I remember.
Besides, like,
that.
The real version, but they released the X-rated version on Playboy, like, on their website.
Oh.
So there's, like, two versions of it, one with the no boobs, and then one with all the boobs, like, all out.
Oh,
but
my
which
God.
Is so funny, it's like, I have my family there, and, like, my family is just seeing all this, and they're just like, like, you know, it's so weird because, like, I have, like, my sister. you know, and my sister's just like there laughing. It's what else can you say about something like that? It's just so crazy.
Yeah.
Just like doing it. And then like we had like Benji from
Good Charlotte.
Yeah, Good Charlotte. Wow. In it. Yeah, he's in there. He's like on the plane or something like that. Like, and then like there was like a girl who is like a famous MySpace girl. She was in it. It was really funny. Like when MySpace was like a whole thing.
Oh, wow.
She was like one of the big ones, and they got her in it. It was so funny because that was like the first thing of like an influencer.
Like the scene queens then, and stuff.
Like they're like, we have to get her in the video too. Forbidden, I forget her name. It was like Forbidden something.
Mm-hmm.
She had like a million followers.
Wow.
For like not doing anything.
My God.
Just for existing, you know?
Wow.
It's like, yeah, we have to get her because she's really popular with all the people right now.
Yeah.
So funny how that works, though. You get famous for like not doing anything.
Yeah. So we got Free Common Sense says that Bloody Hotel Story was insane.
Oh, yeah, God.
Man, I can't.
True story.
That's crazy, man.
All right, I'm working on a generator right now.
Okay. I'm
not sure where you're at.
I'm going over to one. There's a bunch of, circus tents over here.
Cool.
It's the girl
who sings. She like whispers.
Is that Huntress?
She like whistles. I mean,
I think the killer's Huntress, by the way.
Oh, is that the name?
She had the bunny mask.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, here we're coming over. She's chasing this guy, chasing the dude. She got him. I'm
halfway
running. No.
She got it. You.
I saved that guy, and then she chased me down. Now leave me alone. Leave me alone.
Leave I almost got alone. This one.
Oh, man. Screw you, buddy.
He doesn't find me. Okay, I got one.
Okay, I'm off the hook.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm okay. I have a perk where if I save somebody, I can get off the hook. Yeah, it's a good perk. Coming over here, dang it.
I'm gonna work on this one. I'm gonna press that too soon.
But she's taking me down to her lair in the basement. The basement. Damn it. That was my second hook.
Oh, man.
No. You bastard. Oh, I'm gonna get saved.
What are you
doing,
dude?
Whoa. No! Leave me alone! Damn it!
He's got flashing his flashlight at me, that's not gonna do anything.
I might be dead. Oh, no. Okay.
I'm still working on this generator.
Somebody was hiding in a locker and I tried to open it.
No,
and
it
wouldn't
don't.
Let me go in the locker because someone was already in it.
Dang it. She got me.
No.
That was me.
You're down in the basement, huh?
No. Not me. I'm gonna find that stupid generator I was working on.
Oh, someone else is down in the basement.
Shoot.
You're doing really good this round, though, for sure.
Yeah, it does. I usually play as killer. Because it's fun. Oh. I don't know, I want to take a chance to escape, maybe.
I'm coming for you. I'm like right here.
Oh, alright.
I'm coming right around the corner. Ah. Hello.
Thank you.
Let's get out of here. Go this way. Go hide behind this over here. Like right here. Right here. Yep. Always gotta go run away and hide somewhere before you heal.
Yeah.
There you go. There you go.
I'm like bleeding all over the floor. Okay, that generator I already got. See if there's right here. Is this one? I don't know.
Oh, she's coming back. She's coming. Get out of here.
Oh.
Go.
I'm gonna go. Oh, you're kidding.
Oh, no.
So how do I send this one to you, like, just for that thing again?
Oh, are you all done with them, or?
I'm just going to do this one all the way from the evening right there.
Okay.
Okay, yeah, just do that and save it to the camera roll.
Prefer to save the camera roll.
If that has already, then go to photos, the photo gallery. Or actually, no, you need to go to Messenger and go to you. I died.
Did you die?
Yeah. That's.
Did you find it? Yeah. I started doing the
So you want just everything else?
I started doing the filter stuff.
Uh-oh. So you want me to just send everything else that you already did?
I just want to pick up the video.
Uh-oh. This one, because that looks
good. It's me and this other girl, and I don't know where she is, so. She better be working on a damn generator. Fudge, man.
Start saying, I had to flip the TikTok video.
What?
That it starts where it starts. Just let me know which ones you like and just click the ones that you want to use. Just like save as new video clips or
shit.
Something. Yeah, that Huntress is a bitch.
Oh man, I'm totally dead.
Uh-oh.
Ah, shit. I messed up.
Damn. Wait, which one?
Yeah, that song right there, and the flood back in the States. Like, every time we meet our brother, we have like a ritual on the ritual, and that was like the one thing we would always be particular about with that song.
Oh, nice.
One ritual, because there's a pinch harmonic in there where it's like this one.
that one. Mm. See, when it's recorded in the album, but when it was recorded, it had to be punched in because we couldn't get it in time. See, so our goal all the time would be is when we're playing the riff, and like if we hit the pinch harmonic, we're gonna have a good night. The show is gonna be solid.
Cool.
But if we miss it, we're gonna suck ass for this show.
Aw, damn.
Or if we're too drunk or something.
Nice. That was like one for the money too. That was always a good one.
One for the money?
Yeah.
Yeah, like...
Me and my boyfriend actually covered that song. So except it's fun because we do it acoustic. Oh. Like da 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 da. That is taking exceptionally long.
Yeah, that album was really fun to play and make.
Nice. Like
I was listening to a lot of Nickelback.
Wow. Yeah,
that album is based around Nickelback.
Oh, wow.
Dead serious. Every song is a reference to Nickelback. Picture Perfect. Straight up.
Nickelback. Oh my god. Yeah. Nice.
Then, like, my favorite one from the album to play was Firewind. That was my favorite one.
Yeah, it's a good one. I like it. I also like Gorgeous Nightmare.
Oh, Gorgeous Nightmare?
Yep.
Yeah,
I like that
song. That song is awesome.
That video is cool, too. Right. Here we go.
Yeah, that sounds
awesome. Yeah.
What's funny about that video is like that it doesn't relate to the song at all.
Yeah, the
like,
seven deadly sins.
What's
yeah.
going on in the video is nothing to do with the song.
Yeah.
I just think that's so funny. It's like, yeah, we wrote this song about this, you know, whole thing about a girl like, being a gorgeous knight.
Yeah.
Right, let's scrap all that. We're gonna do Seven Deadly Sins instead. Nothing to do with the song. Let's just do that instead, though.
Yeah.
Okay. Which is it's a cool video, but it doesn't make sense to anything that's going on.
Yeah, I like
I
the.
Know,
I
have issues with things like that.
Yeah, I like the Choose Your Fate intro though.
Oh, the
that's
Choose
awesome.
Your Fate intro.
Yeah.
That's a funny story. That was actually made on GarageBand. Like, yeah, that was. It's funny because that was made on GarageBand, and then we have when usually this was before like everyone had like availability to like you know music writing how it is nowadays. Like people can write on their phones now,
right?
Like, make up songs on the phone and stuff like that. So, but we had like a GarageBand demo-ish thing we did, mm-hmm. just because we just like to write something and then show it. So when we brought it into the studio for the producer, he ended up using a lot of the stuff that we had from GarageBand, because that's how lazy he was. He didn't want to. He didn't want to dive into it and redo it like how I wish it would have been. But it still came out good. We added a few more things to make it more up to par. But most of the shit in Choose Your Fate is a bunch of GarageBand sounds.
Oh, good. Wow.
Yeah, that's a lot of fun fact that if you didn't know that. But most of the stuff in Choose Your Fate is GarageBand stuff that you can find in GarageBand.
Nice. Yeah, it's interesting because that intro can like pretty much go with almost any song. Because
Yeah,
not gonna lie, we've used that before for one of our cover shows.
Oh really?
Yeah, because we actually.
We were
though.
About that too, because we wanted it to be like this enveloping, like, hey, we're here, we're coming out. And the producer is just like, you know, if we could take all these sounds from GarageBand and just pop it right in the session. like,
wow. That's cool, just, though.
There was a whole thing about that producer we didn't like. I'm just trying to look really cool right now. I don't know which killer that is, but he can run really fast.
Probably. Is it Ghostface?
I'm not going to go that way. Straight ahead that way.
Let's see where he is.
Going over here.
I'm not sure which one it is. Can't see him.
Yeah, I'm not sure which one it is. He's really fast, though. He can run sprint.
Yeah. Oh, that one. That's the Blight.
What?
The Blight?
Oh, I don't know.
He's new. Well, fairly new.
Yeah, I mean, not quite as fast now.
Yep. Yeah, he's, Well, he didn't get me. I'm gonna just hide in this grass over here and just...
Try to heal yourself. Oh my god, he's taking everybody out. Oh
man.
Oh shit.
Yeah.
Hold
the ear
down and put
your ear
down.
Aw, he found me.
Oh shit. Yeah, I deceive you.
Come on, boo. Have that perk that has like you have a better chance of escaping the hook. Wish I had.
I'm running.
There you are.
You go hide.
Alright. Sorry, broadcast ended, so yay. Oh man, not again. Probably shouldn't be running. But, okay. Yeah, I'm like going over this way, please.
Oh, I see you. Okay.
Yeah, I'm just trying to hide.
Yeah, I'm right next to you. I'm trying to heal you.
Okay.
There you go.
Sweet.
Okay. I got your back, buddy.
Yeah, I'll probably say this will be my last round because my broadcast ended. But for those watching, make sure y'all tune in on June 2nd for the interview with Michael Money.
Awesome. Appreciate it coming on here. It's been awesome. It's been a fun stream.
It's been fun, yeah. We'll have to share some more of those funny tour stories next time.
Oh, yeah. I think you got a few.
Yeah.
I guess I have to tell another one.
Yeah. Oh, cool.
It's kind of like a I have one. It's sort of like a personal story, but it still has stuff to do with BAM, I guess, too.
Ooh.
For sure.
Sweet.
Have a few.
Yeah, I can also have some of the viewers like send in questions if they want to ask you something.
Oh, cool.
During the interview. Cool. Yeah. I'm
always down to answer questions.
Cool. I'm gonna find a generator right now.
Just try not to die.
Yeah, but working on it.
I hear the killer. I don't know where he is. Oh, he's coming.
I don't know where
Screw you, buddy.
I'm like staying on the outside.
I'm out.
Oh, dear. Wait, where are you? Oh, I see.
Oh, my God. He got me. Looks like the Hunchback of Notre Dame or something.
Yeah.
Put me down, Hunchback. Put me down, put me down, put me down, put me down. No. Damn it. Oh, I got up.
Oh, yeah. Sweet. Run.
Oh, he's coming, he's coming.
What is he dancing?
Oh no! Let the girl go!
I think that was, I don't know, that was my second hood. No, I'm just trying to do these, whatever they are, skill tricks, escape things, I guess. I fucked it up. Still kind of somewhat alive.
I don't know what he's doing.
Oh. Well, not good yet.
Yeah,
I am. Whoops.
You did really good.
Thanks. I prefer playing as Cody though. I like playing as Ghostface and Pyramid Head. So, those are fun killers.
What are you doing? What are you doing? Why are you
being
all weird?
Dang, I forgot to press the spectate button. Oh well.
Where's the hatch? Where's the hatch, Joe? Being weird, killer, kill me. He left me. Slowly dying.
Man.
I don't know where the hatch is at all.
Damn.
No idea.
How many gems are left?
Sometimes you can. Oh, yeah, I know. All the gems can never get done. Sometimes you can find the hatch by crawling around, though. It's awesome.
Yeah.
It'll just appear.
That's cool.
But I'll probably die before. I don't know. I don't know where he even went. Where'd he go? Sometimes the killer will do this to fuck with you.
That's
so stupid.
Cool.
Oh, he found the hatch faster. Where'd you go?
Let's go. Gonna go ahead and sign off on this live stream. Thank you to Michael Money for joining me, hanging out during the Radkey request line. Don't forget to tune in June 2nd when the interview will be aired on Rock Ridge Radio. And yeah, just make sure to submit some questions if you want to ask him anything. Submit them to me by, what's the date? I know the date we're doing it, but I don't remember. The Wednesday before that. By the 26th of May, submit your questions to me. You can go shoot me a message on Radkey Request Line Facebook page or Instagram. Yeah.